power of love in which it makes all your senses to move. Not your aql, the mind can't take us into the presence of Prophet ﷺ. The mind can do nothing but illusion and imagination. But Allah's greatest gift is that, "I gave no man two hearts," but this qalb that Allah gave to us and its ability and its immense power. That with this love and this ishq that Allah teaches awliyaullah and awliyaullah go out and teach their students and their students teach students, is that with this love you can move through space and time faster than the speed of thought. That just with that muhabbat, boom, into the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. You will be with whom you love. The words of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ are 110%, 100,000% true. That He was giving for us isharat that, "Keep your love, love for me," and they even came out and said that, "If you don't love Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, you have entered into kufr, you have come against your Islam." But this reality that Allah give to us is, if you have this love, develop this love, you will be in a continuous mirage into the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. And at every moment Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ is in a mirage to Allah's Divinely Presence. It's not one night. That secret of 27 is a bab, is a gate and a door. It's a reflection that Allah name at least once in your busy year, stop and reflect. Ahlul Haqqaiq, all their life is their teaching is to be always at that door, always with this ishq and with this love, waiting at the door, waiting at the door, seeing ourselves at Rawza Sharif, that, "Ana abdukal ajeezu da'eefu miskeenu zalimu jahal." Ya Sayyidi, Ya Rasulul Kareem, Ya Habibul Azeem, you don't turn away any brokenhearted, any poor faqir, anyone whom coming to your gate, to your door, to your threshold. And awliyaullah begin to give a formula that it's the love that will, whew, you fly. Not your aql to think, "Shaykh, oh, I don't know how to increase, I don't know how to feel it." You're not feeling it because you don't really love it. Your love is not yet there. You're imitating, because if they ask how much you love, how much you making salawats per day? None, 200, 1, 5. How are you going to have love like that? You love your kid more than you love. You mention your kid's name all day long. You mention your spouse's name all day long. So they teach us, if you love him ﷺ, mention his name often. Make your lip to be sweet and moist with the praisings upon Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. If we're not feeling the ishq, it's deficient on our side, not their side. All we have to do is love. All you have to do, is there something?
All you need is love. Dun, 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 dun,
dun. Yeah, that's all we need. So that's, they made it so easy. All these other things that people are doing are to tame their nafs, how to make wudu. I saw an interesting video again, you know, I always mention it, and there's every day a new video on wudu. He puts a glove and puts some ink and then shows he makes wudu, and oh my God, all the parts that are still white, he has to cover it with this ink all over it. Ridiculous, ridiculous. This will never get you in the Divine Presence. It may give you a job for an ink company, but it's not the entrance into Divine Presence. Divine Presence doesn't care about that donkey. You are supposed to understand the water, and a little bit you washed with a cup, but you are supposed to wash the inside and the heart. The dhikrullah in tatmanul qulub. That the zikr of Allah open the realities of the heart, then awliya come and begin to teach the greatest zikr of Allah. When say, "Dhikrullahi tatma'inu qulub," what actually some people understood it is the zikr of Allah brings tranquility to the heart. But it's no, actually what is Allah's zikr that brings tranquility to your heart? not the dhikr of saying Allah, but what is Allah's zikr that brings tranquility to your heart? And Allah's zikr was what? In Allahi wa malaikatuhu yusalluna ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah's zikr is the praisings and salawat upon Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And many awliyaullah describe nothing more powerful than that reality, that is the way that Allah wombed that praise upon love with the ishq and praise. For if you begin to praise and that one whom you're praising is so generous that with one of your salawats the nazar of Prophet is coming and begins to dress us. If you're not feeling him وسلم, increase your durood sharif. If you're not feeling the love for him وسلم, increase your durood sharif. Don't focus on the shaykhs, don't focus on people who will let you down and have imperfections and then you say, oh, I don't know this whole Islam thing. No, no, no. Islam is perfect and the people are imperfect and they were not supposed to be perfect. They are not in comparison anywhere to the station of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. They are just drops in a reality and the only purpose for them was to give us a guidance and to be exemplars of the faith, an example. Not to be the one whom is worshipped and personality cult where you think it's all about the person. No, pious people were supposed to give the example, it's not me. Your love is for Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. Are you making lots of durood sharif? Are you praising often? Are you asking all yourself now, I'm at Rawza Sharif. I remember 15 years ago when we were teaching, you make yourself cry at that rawza. If you're a person that doesn't cry, something wrong with your heart. If you come, I will do something to make you cry. Everybody's got to have a tear inside. Now you see the world is crying. So those with family, envision your family in utter despair. All sorts of difficulty are coming to them. At night sit and ask at Rawza Sharif, please, Ya Sayyidi Ya Rasul Kareem, that I'm at your holy threshold, that watch over me, watch over my children, watch over all my loved ones. Please keep your nazar upon me. If I was deficient in my love, forgive me. If I didn't do enough to show you my love and I worship the dunya, forgive me. If I didn't do enough to show my love for you, forgive me. Build a relationship at the threshold of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. And all these kalam we're reading on how much they were crying and how much they were crying. They were crying at the threshold of Prophet ﷺ, that, take my case to Allah, make sure that I'm protected from all the bad that's coming and all my loved ones don't need to break me down and crush me. I'm already asking at your threshold, I'm asking and praying, Sayyidi Ya Rasul Kareem, that you are the Kareem, that please watch over them, dress them, bless them and forgive me and increase my love for you. So that at every moment my thought is about you ﷺ. I want to take my tasbih out and I want to begin to praise upon your reality. And every time I hear a praising, a tear begins to come into my eye and into my heart. And that's what we talked last night when Allah, when they were asking, Ya Rabbi, where are you? He says, in this voice of yours, this love that you have, and you begin to recite, I am the love in that voice. And when you begin to cry and cry out of things that are good, not cry that something bad left you and somebody repoed your car. People crying now because their cars have all been repossessed if they don't make the payment. No, no, when you're crying from love and ishq, from what Allah loves, and you begin to cry at Prophet's door, please save my family, please save all my young ones, save me from difficulty and grief. As soon as you cry, then Allah begin to teach, I am that emotion in your face, I am the tear that you are shedding. Means that Allah is the emotion of all our good emotions. If we have love, that is Allah's Divinely Presence is the love. If you're devoid of love, you're devoid of Allah. I am the love that emanates within your heart, bring me into your heart, bring my muhabbat into you and you feel my presence. When there's no love in the heart means Allah is not in the heart. Love is faith, faith is love. We say love and people are like from other cultures that, what are you talking about love so much? We're not talking sex, we're talking love and muhabbat. Every beatific emotion is Allah's Divinely Presence. When you have beatific crying, it's Allah that making the tears to flow. I am that beatific emotion that exists within you. And when you're angry and bad, that is Satan, not Allah. Allah doesn't exist within that qadab, that's not to be attributed to Allah, that is the attribute of shaitan. So then Allah said, come to Rahman, come to everything beatific and good and warm and loving, and leave everything that turned away from Allah's rahmah and Allah's warmth and became cold and dirty. So every beatific emotion is Allah's Divinely Grace upon us. So as soon as we increase that love, you'll be flying. Every night will be an Isra wal Miraj of love to Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. Before the dunya was busy and people were running, now Allah with immense haybah, immense majestic might, His immense love for Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, that now my Muhammadiyun Mahdi, he's the king of all the memes of Hidayat and Hadi. He's the Muhammad and Hadi, the one of the highest, the only highest Muhammadan guide now entering into dunya. And ihtiram and love for Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, as if and when you go to other countries, they stop all the traffic and to show a majestic might of the ruler, all the traffic lights stop, all the people are brought out onto the streets and the leader drives by uninterrupted with all his flags on his car. Allah said, for the ihtiram of Prophet ﷺ, I'm about to turn the lights off everywhere. In one instant he sent something into the earth that everything closed off. Everyone sent home, everything that was a distraction that took people away from the oneness of Allah, and he returned them back to humanity for the reality of that light. The ihtiram and azimat al Nabi ﷺ, that the Muhammadan guide is about to step into the earth. And Allah says, He commands your full attention and shut lights on everything. There's no business to go to, there's no work to go to, everybody is now mandated to sit at home. And even they're now saying that not even from place to place to move, sit buyutum, like the ants, get into your home and your dwelling. Outside your home you should be in difficulty unless they have a permission for the rizq, sustenance for food. But the azimat of Allah now showing this ihtiram and respect, He commands your full attention. Sit in your home and see if you believe, return back to your humanity. And as soon as they sit in the home, the facade of shaitan is crumbling. He had everybody by distraction and running. Now they don't know even what to do in their home, and Allah giving an opportunity, sit in your home and begin to meditate. Sit in your home and read from these knowledges. Sit in your home and make your salawat. Sit in your home and enjoy your surroundings and go back to the way of love. And this is for what? For this Nur Muhammadi ﷺ that now moving into the earth. We pray that Allah grant us that light, bless us with that light. Give us to be from ashiqeen that with this love in an instant, as soon as we're reciting, we are in their presence. The love is so powerful, when we recite about Sayyidina Mahdi salam, no doubt we are in the presence of Sayyidina Mahdi salam. When we recite with the love of Imam Ali salam, no doubt we are in the presence of Imam Ali salam. These recitations are powerful force, like a Jedi force. as soon as you recite it you're in their presence. They don't need a ship, they don't need anything to take us there. All they need is begin to recite it with love, the souls are moving in an instant in their presence to be dressed by them, blessed by them, their nazar upon us, their perfection, whom their actions and their deeds were correct. They dress us from their lights, they bless us from their lights, and they send their madad upon our souls. We pray that Allah dress that, bless that, increase that. Wa yansurukallahu nasran aziza ya Rabbi. Wa yansurukallahu nasran aziza ya Rabbi. Support us with a mighty support ya Rabbi. Yansurukallahu nasran aziza. Bi hurmati Muhammad al-Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al-Fatiha. Alhamdulillah, everybody is on Isra wal Miraj. If you don't feel it, increase your love for Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. Every zikr, every association, especially these next few nights, see yourself in the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. Don't ask to see his holy face, we're not at that level of, or we should feel a shyness in dealing with that. That I want to see your beatific foot. This beautiful holy foot with beautiful sandal, that my station is inshaAllah always under your holy foot. Mm-hmm. Just keep me at your holy foot and dress me, bless me, and that is my miraj, that is the greatest gift that if Allah want to grant to us is that station to be under the foot, under the qadam and nazar of Sayyidina Muhammad inshaAllah. إلى شرف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى صحابه الكرام وعلى مشايخنا في طريقة النشبندية العالية بنية ختم خوجگان مدد يا سيدي يا سلطان الأولياء شيخ عبد الفايز الدارستاني سلطان الأولياء شيخ محمد نازم عادل حقاني مولانا شيخ الشام كباني شيخ عدنان كباني شيخ محمد عادل عبد الخالق الخشتواني صاحب زمان سيد محمد المهدي عليه السلام روح الله سيدنا عيسى عليه السلام سيف الله سيدنا عليه السلام ثم سبق الصديق سيدنا عمر سيدنا عثمان إمام سلمان حسين سيدنا فاطمة زهرة السلام شامة الفرداني عبد الرؤوف اليمني يوسف الصديق إمام العارفين سلمة القائمين التيار معروف بين محمد بن غاب سلام سلام وحسين محمد المهدي سلام إمام علي سلام أسلم سيدنا إمام حسين السلام وسائر وسادتنا والصديقين الفاتحة
Welcome to Muhammadan Way YouTube channel, your premier destination for videos on Sufi spirituality, classical Islamic teachings, and realities of the soul. With a library of over 1,000 videos and new titles uploaded weekly, join us to discover true meaning and inner peace in our often troubled world. Click the link now to subscribe.